Hi, buddy. Hey. How you doing, buddy?
Good.
You had a good day?
Yeah. Hey, guys. It's Monday, 5:51 p.m. I am on my way to Walmart Pharmacy. Basically, last night after editing my video, I've been having toothache problems for a minute now. Probably about a year ago, I got one over here pulled, and almost immediately after getting that one pulled, then this one started hurting. I tried to hold out as long as I could. Finally got to a point where I needed to go to a dentist, so I went. I don't like inner pain, y'all, but I went, and they saw that I had an infection in my gums, you know, my nerves and stuff from that tooth. So they prescribed me with some antibiotics and some pain meds, which I took that stuff for like a week or two. Excuse me, just to fight the infection. And I was taking the pain meds as needed. But of course, quite naturally, everything ran out. Last month, I started having issues. So they ended up, after that appointment, they ended up setting my new appointment 2 months out, you guys. So last month, I was experiencing some pain, and I decided that I couldn't deal with the pain anymore. So I tried to get my appointment rescheduled, you guys, and they kept giving me the runaround. It was either the person who does the scheduling is not in, or she's on break, we'll have her call you back. And I did that for like a week straight and never got any contact. So I just was like, you know what? I put up with it. And if you're on Medicaid, you know sometimes it's hard to get doctors. It's hard to find doctors that take your card, let alone once you find a doctor that takes your card, they make it like hell to get in, or, you know, to get the help you need. But anyway, so last night I started experiencing some real bad pains. Couldn't really sleep, so I basically decided this morning that I was going to try to go to a dentist here locally and try, you know, just pay for it outright. But y'all know, I haven't worked in a while, so I didn't have that kind of money. And even though my mom was willing to help me pay for it, like, I'm not about to get her to pay that kind of money for me to get my tooth pulled when next week I can get it pulled for free. Well, not, it's free for me. But, you know, Medicaid would cover it. So, I was just like, I'll just have to put up with the pain. So, I've been dealing with that all day. That's why this is, like, the first snippet you guys see of me. I did happen to catch Sheldon getting off the bus today, though. Well, I caught him coming into the house. But, yeah, so that's what I'm doing right now. I'm going to get ready and go to Walmart. Okay, guys, I am at Walmart now. I'm about to go into the pharmacy. Mask up first. Then I'm gonna go in and pick up these meds. I know y'all seen me have a little jam session. But that's because my mom came through with the cooling and heating beads. I heated that up, put that on my mouth for about 20 minutes. Well, on the side of my face for about 20 minutes. Before that, well, while that was heating up, I took a BC powder, which technically I'm not supposed to have because of my kidneys, because it has aspirin in it. But you guys, I have been staying away from aspirin for a couple of years now, since I had my surgery done. So I feel like popping a BC every once in a while shouldn't hurt me too bad. So yeah, I'm feeling a little better right now. I don't have the pain. So I'm about to go ahead and pick up these meds. So I go ahead and get that in my system. That way tonight when I get ready to go to bed, it won't be hurting me as bad as it was. It was a little wait, but it wasn't too bad. I wasn't gonna come back on and film after getting it. But I was walking out the store and I saw this girl coming up. She was walking behind my car as I was walking to the car. And I saw her, and y'all, she had split dye hair. One side was jet black and the other side was this beautiful lime, just beautiful lime green color. Oh my God, it was so beautiful. I literally, through the mask, I was smiling. I knew she couldn't tell I was smiling, but I literally just said to her in passing, "I love your hair." And she stopped in her tracks, you guys. And she was like, "Really?" And I was like, "Yes, it's beautiful. You are rocking it." And she was like, "Thank you so much." You know, she was like, "I dyed it yesterday and I've been a little self-conscious about it, you know, because it's something different and something new." And she was like, "You're the first person other than my friend," which her friend was standing there with her. She was like, "You're the only person outside of my best friend who told me it looks good." And she was like, "Being that you're a complete stranger and you tell me that," she said, "now I can rock it in confidence." See, that's what I'm saying. It don't cost anything to be kind to someone. Even just in passing, I didn't know me telling that girl that was going to uplift her spirits. You know what I'm saying? Like, you never know what effect you can have on somebody depending on your mood. You feel me? One simple act of kindness, her whole day could have been crap, y'all. But because I gave her that little compliment, it made her day. You know what I'm saying? Be kind to someone. It's much easier to be nice than it is to be a butthole, I'm telling y'all. It really and truthfully is. Don't you put that there in front of me. But yeah, so just on today, or whenever I upload this, which is probably going to be tomorrow, Tuesday, be kind to someone today. If it's no more than a simple, "Hey, how you doing? I like your outfit. I like them shoes." Something. You never know whose life you might touch that day, whose life you might change that day, whose life you might even save that day. Even through all my pain, I've been in pain all day long. And I could have just been the rudest person ever. I could have not said anything. Or, you know, I could have rolled my eyes at it or whatever. But I like things like that. I like people who are different. You know, I like eccentric. You know, that's just me. Oh my God, the license plate is my initial CLG. I love it. Can I have your point? It's the most fine too. I paint that baby yellow. Ooh. But anyway, yeah, you know, I could have been rude. I could have just, because I've been in pain all day, I could have had a spank attitude and not said nothing to her. You know what I'm saying? But no matter what you're going through, I always try to aim for kindness. Because one day you're going to need that kindness returned to you. I'm trying to debate whether or not I'm going to stop at the Chinese restaurant and get me some soup. Because I haven't eaten anything since yesterday. And I'm low-key starving. Because I really ain't going to eat. Because my mouth's been hurting and it seems like everything that I do with my mouth or surrounding my mouth just creates pain. But since I got this pain medicine, I think I'm gonna try to eat some, at least put something on my stomach, because I've been staying hydrated. Even that's been painful. Cold water, I even tried room temperature water and it still hurt, but I knew I had to put some fluids in my body. But I'm burnt out on water, y'all, so I might be about to stop here and get some soup. Although I could have went inside the store and got, but I just don't, that was right there in Walmart, but excuse me, I just low-key don't want to go back inside another store. Although I do have some chicken broth at home and some beef broth. I don't know. And I got some noodles, so I could drink the juice off of that. I think I'm gonna just wait till I get home, y'all. I just talk myself through it, so that's what I do sometimes. I talk through things and come out with the best possible outcome. And yeah, even though if I go to the Chinese restaurant, it'll already be prepared. All I have to do is get home, pop the top, and commence to consuming. But I really don't feel like spending my money, so. And I know I got things at home I can use. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and go home, you guys. It's starting to drizzle again. I guess I'll turn the camera around so you guys can see this weather. Which, technically, this is my kind of weather. I love this type of weather because it means I can put my blanket in the dryer, let it warm up a little bit. Oh my God, get nice and toasty, cuddle up on the couch with myself, with my single life. And just love on me. It is currently Tuesday, and let me turn this down. I'm sorry, loyalties life. I'm catching up on my loyalties life, not royalty, loyalties life 20, baby. Catching up on her. I just recently subscribed to her. She subscribed to me, and so, you know, I'm just showing a little love that way. If y'all like to, go check her out. She does pranks, vlogs, traveling, a little bit of traveling and stuff like that. That's what I'm watching right now. She's up to Atlanta. Or whatever. So yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. I'm not doing too much today. Just basically, like, glare city. I can see myself. Anyway, and then you can see loyalty. Anyway, I'm sorry. I'm cracking myself. Let me take my glasses off. Whoa. Damn. But anyway, just wanted to come give you guys a little update, because I am going to edit this video today and have it posted for today. But it's not an exciting video today at all. Like I told y'all yesterday, I'm dealing with the toothache, but I get that taken out next Monday. Ooh, it ain't coming fast enough. But yeah, so I'm getting that tooth pulled. And honestly, y'all, I'm thinking about talking to my dentist and seeing if I could go ahead and get all the wisdom teeth, all the back teeth, just snatched out of my head. Ain't nobody gonna be all back off up in there. You know what I'm saying? I ain't doing all of it. Because I have a weird feeling, because that's what happened with this side. I got this tooth pulled, and then this side started hurting, because while this side was healing, I was favoring this side, and then this side started hurting. So once this side healed, I started favoring this side, and I just have a weird feeling. And I might be about to speak this into existence. Because, you know, they say what you put out in the atmosphere is what you get back. But I have a real feeling that once I get this pulled, another one is going to start acting crazy. I rebuke it in the mighty name of Jesus, but we don't know. So yeah, I'm basically just sitting here. I just got through taking some ibuprofen and amoxicillin to help with my tooth. And there go them arms again, y'all. Y'all can just from now on call me the queen, okay? Queen. I'm Heather. But yeah, I just got through taking those medicines, and I just got through doing my, let me see if I can kind of roll over and grab it. Because I'm low-key camped out on the couch, but I'm always low-key camped out on the couch. Don't judge. This is what my mom bought me, you guys. Isn't it beautiful? Red, blue, and white beads in it. So you can tell I just got through using it. It still got a little humidity in there. But this is what the back looks like. It's a pad. You put this side on your face, and you cover this side with, like, a towel or something. So you don't burn your hair, because it gets pretty hot in them, 45 seconds that you heat it up, because you put it in there for 25 seconds at first. You open it up, test to see if it's hot. If it's not hot enough, you do it in 15 minute increments till it gets to the warmth that you want. You don't want it to get too hot, because I don't know if it'll bust open or what, but I haven't gone any longer than 55 seconds, you guys. But yeah, you put this on your face, and when I tell you, it's like instantly it draws all the pain out. It takes away all your troubles. No, it's like, no. But yeah, and what I like to do is I put it on this side, and once I can't feel the heat on this side anymore, by that time this side has cooled down some, so then I flip it over. I try to get it. I know that grass is wet out there, y'all, and they out there call themselves cutting grass. That's defeating the purpose, because the water is feeding the grass. So you sitting there cutting it, and next week it's gonna be back looking like it looks. Look at that. Hey, I'm gonna come when I'm filming. Y'all here all the time in the world. But anyway, what I like to do is I like to then test this side, and then I like to get a little double usage out of it. You're not supposed to use it longer than 20 minutes, but I like to put it on this side and just feel the beads moving around. Look at them. Oh my god. And I tell y'all, it feels so good. But yeah, so update on that. I am feeling a lot better. I'm still having a little pain, but that's like if I try to, if I drink something, especially something cold, because your mouth then becomes cold, so when you rest your mouth, your tongue rests up against your, you know, the back of your teeth or whatever. And, I did eat something this morning, though. I did. I had no salad. Because really and truthfully, I don't want to be doing too much chewing, but, you know, with my salad, I just did the lettuce and cheese, so I wouldn't be chewing on nothing meaty or anything like that, anything kind of hard or solid, so, yeah. That's the update. Sheldon should be home in like an hour. So I was gonna try to take me a little nap, but I can do that once he's home, safely home, in his zone, in his room. I'm still gonna try to convince him, y'all, to do something with me. I don't know why he's in this mood where it's like he feels like he can't come up with any good ideas. But then again, when I come up with an idea, it's like he still don't wanna do it. So I don't know. So what he's been doing, y'all, he's been doing it ever since quarantine. He's gotten accustomed to being in the house with just his underwear on. But I noticed that since I've been filming, he makes it a point to hurry up, get off that bus, and go run in that room and put on his underwear, because he know I'm not gonna film him in his underwear. But at the beginning of the vlog, y'all are gonna see what he does when he takes his bath. He literally will open both doors, his bedroom door, because nine times out of ten, when Sheldon's in his room, he has the door closed. The only time his door is open is when he's out of his room or when he's getting ready to go to bed, because he doesn't like the dark, so he'll open his room door and turn on the hall light, which I hate, but he does that. So he, in the beginning, you're going to see him with his door wide open, TV, hecka loud, and then the bathroom door is open, and you're going to see me in the mirror waving and shaking, or shaking my head, I forget which one I did. But yeah, he likes to be able to hear his TV while he's in the tub. Instead of just pausing the TV and coming back to it, he likes to have that entertainment while he's in the tub. Then had the nerve to tell me it's no different than me taking my phone in the bathroom when I go take a bath. So, teachers, he has a cell phone, so why not take your cell phone? But anyhow, that's just him, one of his weird quirks, you guys. So yeah, I'm gonna get off here because I've been on here for almost 9 minutes. But yeah, that's the update. I am feeling a little better, but I'm still having some pain, and I'm just trying to put up with it until next week. So I might come back on. It just depends on after I start up putting these clips together and editing them, seeing how long they are. If they're not too long, I might go ahead and upload it, or I might add a little bit more to it, but, yeah.